Hello and welcome to the MGP Portable Video Player Slim Station Chinese Sonic Head Game Player video game thingy that it's listed as on eBay. Yes, there's a million and one different kind of these. They come in a variety of different colours, but I managed to find one here for a couple of quid. You can get these for a couple of dollars from eBay, although the packaging seems to be a little bit different, they do all appear to be exactly identical on the inside. So, what is this? It's a small games console plug and play. So essentially, it's like my good old Jack specific plug and play TV games, that sort of stuff. It just comes with a bunch of NES type titles on here, which is pretty interesting. It can be a gift, a TV game, a flashlight, or a laser. It's lying about laser. Or maybe it is. I don't know. I think it's just lying about the flash. It's just a flashlight from what I've seen. There's no laser on it. Unless I haven't found it. Let's see. It's 5 plus. For whatever reason. Function. Laser lamp. Car gifts. Flashlight. TV games. Only one AAA battery supply. Included in the gift box is a games console, manual, and an AV cable. Product color. Obviously, it's blue, innit? Choking hazard of small parts in the plastic bag to save the children, blah, 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 blah. All that good stuff. And a load of rubbish, which I'm sure they really aren't. Probably not. I don't know. We'll get to that later. So let's have a little look at the unit itself. Now, I got the blue one simply because, well, it's clearly designed like Sonic's head. That's essentially what it is. It's a complete ripoff of Sonic the Hedgehog. There are a bunch of other colours, of course, based on your favourite characters from Sonic the Hedgehog, like Knuckles. There's a red one, there's a yellow one, there's an orange one. So it's essentially just a ripoff of Sonic to go for your nostalgia, which is pretty darn cool. The unit itself is really tiny. Now, I've got man-sized hands, and to be honest, it doesn't feel that bad in the hands. It's actually quite grippy. You just use your joystick here, and you press the buttons here. It is a little bit tiny. It feels like you're on a Game Boy Advance SP. If your hands are a little bit too big for that, then yes, you'll be like me. You'll be a little bit scrunched over like this. I don't mind it so much. I can play for hours and hours on end like this completely fine. Here's the flashlight. Pretty darn cool. The back, obviously, for the single AAA battery. You get hours of life out of this. It's really, really impressive. It has the joystick, of course, up, down, left, right, diagonal, whichever way you pointed it. There's a start button, a B button, A button, and a T button for turbo. Now, the funny thing is, turbo is literally just mapped to B. I don't know if you can swap that. I've looked in the manual, and there doesn't seem to be a way to swap it. Reset button at the top. Nice clicky button. AV out. And, of course, the power switch, which is a nice, lovely, solid switch. I like them when the switches are not buttons, because buttons can fail. Switches can also fail, but they're less likely to when they're little switches like that. You're less likely to break them. Absolutely fantastic for kids, honestly. This is brilliant. There are a couple of faults with this that I can see already. As you can see, there's a little bit of plastic sticking out there. I might have to, file that off, I guess. I don't know. And, obviously, as you can see, it spins. Why does it spin? I don't know. Is that a feature? Is it supposed to be like that? I don't think so. So when you're going to be going left, I can already see that's going to be a problem now. We lost focus there for a second. Annoying. But yes, buttons feel okay. Feels pretty cool. What else do we get inside of the box? Foam. I don't know what's supposed to be in there, but it's not there anymore. Maybe the laser light. Well, it's not there. Finger hole! I love finger holes. Pull that out. Manual. The manual is a small piece of paper. Portable gift games console, 3 fire buttons, super classic games, TV output, interface, AV cable included, support system, NTSC, and PAL. I'm in the UK, works completely fine. Built-in laser lamps, built-in flashlight, powered from one AAA batteries. Plural, guys. Plural. Why is it batteries when there's only one? Bothers me. let's see. Notice, please avoid placing products in high temperatures. Yeah, all the basic stuff. This isn't really a manual, is it? But this is the manual. Problem, no picture on the screen. Have the batteries been installed correctly? They've changed the name now. The MiPad-80 Play Vision Portable turned on. That's a completely different name. They've got a million different names. Let's see, is it connected properly? Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, no game sound. Picture is blinking or distorted. Power off the portable and try again. No power. Have the batteries been installed correctly? Check whether the battery capacity is too low. Yeah, all that good stuff. What else is in here? The 2.5mm connector with mono audio. I hate that. But this is why you buy one of these. You get it for like 99p off eBay or Amazon or from wherever else. Cheap as hell. Splits the audio. So it comes through both speakers. That's essentially why I do it. There you go. Put that on there. Suddenly you've got left and right speakers. Because you don't want it coming out of just one speaker. I'd rather it come out of both. Technically it's stereo, but it's not stereo because it's not got left or right. It just comes out of both speakers. Always buy one of these for your plug and plays. Very important. Plus, I've been using this one for years. This is the same one you've been seeing for years in my videos. Fantastic. So yeah, what are the games like? Let's go have a look. Alrighty, welcome to the menu for this MGP portable video player Sonic Head thing that you can buy for literally a couple of bucks. Here's the main menu right now. It comes straight up as two options for languages, Chinese and English. I would prefer English to be number one, and for the main reason of that is, I'll just show you now. Let's jump into English. Let's just say we're playing a game right about now, and let's say we want to change games. Yep. Straight into the main menu again. So we've got to go down to English again. Now, eventually, I suppose you will learn what the games are, and the language doesn't really matter. It's literally just for the game names. Now, this is an 89-in-1. I don't know if they're repeated or not, so let's just quickly go through all the games. Angry Bird 3. I don't know if there's a 1 and 2. I find it absolutely fascinating that there's an Angry Bird NES type game out there based on the actual modern game. Yes, they've retroized the game. Fascinating. Contra. Good old Contra. Super Mario, Spartan, Arkanoid, Tetris, Aladdin, Adventure. All the good ones, all your favourites from back in the day. Gradius, Legend of Cage, Chinese Chess World Cup, 942, fantastic shmup. Night Tank, F1 Race, Macross, Kung Fu, Road Fight Circus, Galaga, Desert Tank, Mario Bros. Yes, the original Mario Bros, not Super Mario Bros. Yeah, this was actually a really fun one. I actually enjoyed that one. Lode Runner 2, Dig Dug, I'll absolutely adore that. 5 Chess, Bomberman, Puyan, Lunar Ball, all this, all your favourites. All your favourites. Star Force, Donkey Kong 1, 2, and 3. So good. Mappy, Excitebike, Ninja 1. I kind of wish Puyo Puyo was on here. I don't think it is. There's Pac-Man. Oh, so good. Formation Z, Birdweek, Galaxian, Joust. Oh, absolutely adore Joust. See, for a couple of dollars, this is absolutely fantastic, and it's powered by one AAA battery. So cool. SU Dig Dug? I don't know what SU Dig Dug is. I don't think there was a Super Dig Dug, was there? I don't know, so I'm assuming there's some repeats going on here. We see Arkanoid again, SU Pac-Man, Donkey Kong 3 again, Bomberman again. So I'm not sure what the differences between all these are. Galaxing? Final Arkanoid, I think? I'm not too sure. But let's just jump straight in, straight at the top, with Angry Bird 3. I'm not going to jump into all the games, I'm just going to play the ones that are of note to me and the ones I actually kind of enjoy and see how well they play. Audio level seems to be different on each ROM, and I'm not editing the video footage to change volume, so the volume is what the volume is. Alright, let's go on number one episode. Level one. Come on, anytime today. There we go. Right, I just find it fascinating that they've made a Angry Bird NES type game. Okay, so just for clarity's sake, there is a delay between what I say and what you see. This is just based on my technique on how I record. I'm just too lazy to sync it up, but just know that it is a second or two out of sync. So for example, right now I'm going to press up. There you go. There's a little bit of a delay there. Down. There you go. See, a little bit of a delay. Alright, so with... I find this game so fascinating. In your face! And I just fire it in the same spot again, and I assume it's... That's one of the problems with these. Because it's a digital and not analog way of doing it, you can basically beat the game by just knowing which angle to fire from at this. I mean, you can with the analog ones, but it's more precise, I'd say, on the modern games, obviously.
Well, I think I did it. Yay! Winning. Next game. That was Angry Birds. Obviously, I'm going to jump into Contra. I don't know. I don't know what the difference is between all of these. Let's go on Contra 6. I don't know what the difference is. I think it's just different levels. I love... two players. Two players. You see that? Two players. How? Fascinating. I kind of wish you could actually plug in another controller. Okay, so let's just have a look at this. Alright, so the B button fires, A to jump, and the turbo button is just jump forever. Pretty cool. Alright, let's do this. The joystick isn't actually that bad. I actually quite enjoy this. Ooh, I'll take that, please. Get out of my way, you can't hit me. Can't touch this. Whoa! I ain't fighting you. Fight yourself. Whoop! Whoop, 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 whoop. Ah. Wait. Oh, we've got infinite lives. This is cheating. Oh, you can actually beat these. It's been a while since I got to this level in Contra. Die, you scrub. There you go. You can hear me clicking, but you can also see the difference in the delay like I mentioned earlier. So don't be put off by that too much. This is not... There's obviously... The game's obviously not dated. It'd be completely unplayable if it was delayed as bad as you can see in here. No, it's literally just the way I record. It's the Elgato. I refuse to get the newer one. I'm sticking with the original Elgato. Just because it records everything. Oh, that was just the... that was like the most unfortunate jump. Wait, how do I get across there then? Do I have to kill that? Can I kill that? I don't know, it's been so long since I got to this level. It's a trap! It's a trap! It's a trap! You know what? You're a trap. It knows when I jump! How do you get past it? What? What? You know what? Dad, you need to get good. Alright, Super Mario. You guys know what Super Mario is. Do I need to show you that? Goonies. We all know Goonies. Gradius. Absolutely fantastic game. Look, I'm from 1942. I'm probably absolute garbage at it. So many of these games I grew up playing, and then you just play them when you're older, and your just reflexes just aren't as good as they used to be, and it's just... Rawr. It's so sad and disheartening. Alright, so let's see. Alright, so the B button, fire as usual. I kind of wish the buttons were swapped so that at least we'd be able to use turbo. Whoop, whoop, whoop. So the turbo is mapped to dodge, which is pretty darn cool. Did a little loop-de-loop, flip-de-flip. But yeah, pretty fun stuff. It's 1942. I have this on PlayStation 2. 1942 and 1943, was it? Do enjoy it. Yeah. Love that. I will take that, please. Thanking you. Everything is happy now. Yep, good old 942. Plays exactly as you'd expect. It's literally based on you just the way you play. And because it is emulated on a chip, I suppose, and also because it's analog, you could plug this into a CRT and the delay would be completely fine. I don't see much of a delay. But I never have and I never will. I know lots of people care about reaction times and stuff, but you just have to adjust your way, how you play, like, especially with Super Mario Bros. And Super Mario Land. It's just, it works, it's fine. The delay is so minimal, it's not a problem. I've never understood people's problem with it, but hey, maybe I'm just old and grumpy and just, meh, it works, meh. Again, with the language barrier, meh. Luckily, if you press right, it skips a whole page. So you can get to your favorite game as much as you want. There's Mario Bros. Again. Oh, I did like that one. I kind of want to play it. But I want to see what Dig Dug's like. Let's jump onto Dig Dug. Good old Dig Dug. Two-player Dig Dug. Oh, man. This actually looks really, really good. Oh, the turbo works. Fantastic. Damn it. I didn't get there in time. Fight me. Fight me. I'm just too good for you. Come at me. Yeah, come on, come on. Come at me. Come on. I'm gonna eat you, and I'm gonna eat your dragon friend too. Yeah! Turbo button. See? I kind of had a feeling that the turbo button wouldn't be on that button, but thankfully it was. Now, our issue over here is this guy. Oh, that didn't work how I wanted it to. Mistakes were made because Dan forgot how to play Dig Dug. To be honest, the controls aren't the best. Ooh, almost. Oh god, they're coming! Run away! Oops. Oh no, one's getting away! No! No! Get over here! No! Get over here! Oh, that was unfortunate. Yeah, the controls aren't as robust as I remember, but then again, maybe I'm remembering it different. Yeah, I think I am just remembering it different, because obviously it's on a grid format, so if I press left while I'm in the middle there, it won't work. Right, you! Get over here! I'm eating you. I need to get them crushed by the rocks, but I was never any good at that. Never was. So I don't think I'll get better now, unless I practice a million times. The game seems to be running a little faster than the original. You! Let's do this. There you go, I'm gonna eat you. Oh, you rude. I'm gonna eat you too. Come on, Mr. Dragon Mans. I'm gonna eat you. Come here. Get over here. Nom 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 nom. Oh, Dig Dug. I could play this for hours. You guys know. Alright. Da-da-da. Let's see. Do I wanna play Puyan? I wanna play that Bomberman, Olympic, Nuts and Milk. I do wish Puyo Puyo was on here. Sad times, Mappy. Excitebike. Everyone loves Excitebike. There's just so many games on there. I wish I could show them all to you, but it's just a case of not enough time in the day. I would show you. They all work completely fine. I'm just showing you just because I love you guys. You know, it's just regular good old Pac-Man. We'll have a look at SU Pac-Man, see if there's any difference. I don't know what SU stands for. Come on, over here. Come on. There we go. I love how they've all got their own personalities. This is what always drove me to playing Pac-Man, was that they all had their own individual personalities. Like, one would chase you, one would avoid you. It's always fascinating. Like, even in the original Pac-Man, it was completely fascinating to me that one would go for you, one wouldn't. So you know which ones to look out for most of the time. One will try heading you off. Well, I'm going to come and eat you too. But yeah, Pac-Man. You guys know I love Pac-Man. How could I not show you guys Pac-Man? You guys know I'm obsessed with showing you Pac-Man. If I've got Pac-Man on a system, I'm going to show you Pac-Man, damn it. Oh, they're chasing me. There you go, see. Look, see, I'm getting engrossed now. I'm not even... I was meant to stop then. I will say one thing for the controller. The joystick actually spins. Yeah, if I literally twist it, it actually spins, which makes it very annoying for when you want to go left and right. All right, let's have a look at SU Pac-Man. What is the difference? I don't know. What is SU Pac-Man? Concerning. Doesn't work. Okay. I guess it doesn't work. We'll give it one last try, but I don't think it works. We'll try SU Puyan as well. Oh, that one actually works. I don't know what the difference is. If anything. This is too long of an intro. Yes, I know, they're kidnapping our babies, we must stop them, blah blah blah. Wait, is that different colours? What? Oh, crap. Don't shoot me! Get over here. I was never any good at this. Timing is not my thing. You! No! One got past! No! Ah, oh, crap baskets. Oh, they're climbing the ladder. We need to kill them. Kill. Luckily, I've got a turbo button. I saw that. You put that down. Put that down. Yeah, you collapse and die, you scrub. No one likes you. Meh. Leave my babies alone. Meh. They're my babies. If I want to eat them, I'll eat them, damn it. Yeah, I think it's a little sprite change. Same game, just sprite changed. I don't know what on earth that thing was. Don't you dare shoot anything in my face. Thank you. How do I get those guys down there? Yeah, they're trying to eat me. I think I have to shoot that. I can't quite remember. Memory serves bad. No, can't shoot that. But yes, we win. We won a cookie. Next game. But yeah, there's not really much more to show, to be honest. I do want to play some Joust, though. Let's find some Joust. No, I want to play some Joust. Joust and Galaxian. But first, Joust. Ah, good old Joust. My first experience of this was on the Game Boy. Joust and Defender cartridge. Got it for a pound at a car boot sale when I was like 5. So good, I was completely addicted to Joust. And then when I found out it was actually based on an arcade machine, I sought out the arcade machine and found it in my favorite little arcade place in the town I grew up. Because they had every arcade. They had every single one, more or less. Over the years, anyway. Well, they just changed them over time. So I've played most of the original arcades. It was fantastic. I was very fortunate to... And when I found out this... Why did I do that? I was very fortunate to have grown up where I did. To play all the arcade originals. And, of course, the ports to NES. Ooh. Got you. I want to eat you. There we go. See, you don't need fast, stupidly amazing freaking response times. Like, oh, what's the delay like? Meh. See, it's not a big deal. You just have to be good at games. Like me. Even though I died like 12,000 times. But that wasn't because of my reaction time. That was based on me being an idiot. But yeah. I amaze myself at how bad I am at games sometimes. I may as well turn into Darkseid bloody Phil at how bad he is. Nah, I'll never... Oh, YouTube drama. Yeah, we don't touch that with a 10-foot barge pole. Alright, so, what's left? There's so many games I want to show you, but I just want to play my favourites because I'm the one recording it. Let's go for Galaxian. Let's finish up with some Galaxian and then go out some final thoughts. Oh, so good. I mean, I could just hold the turbo button. Doesn't fire much faster. It does the job. Good old Galaxian. You get away from me. Meh. No one likes you. Always deal with the bottom ones first. But never destroy an entire line, though, because if I remember rightly, if you destroy that, it gets a little bit... Oh, gets a little bit funky. Oh, no. Now it's going to get... I am Leet. You cannot kill what you cannot shoot. You can try, but I am too amazing. I'm actually surprised I've not died yet, he says as he dies. No, I'm still not died. Miracles. Ooh. Oh, I think they're going to get me now. He's going to get me now. I knew it. Dagnabbit. Ah, not too bad, though. There's only a couple left, thankfully. Ready? Damn right, we're gonna finish them off. Come on, come at me. Come at me. I'll take you out. Nailed him. See? Reaction time. Oh, no. We aggroed them so... it's always amused me in this game where you just one ship against all this massive fleet, but you can take them out. Turns out you're the invader. Surprise! I don't actually know. I've never really known what the box art said about Galaxian. I know it was an arcade game, but I'm just saying, like, what's the story? There's always a story. They always wrote one. But anyway, let's go out for some final thoughts right about now. Alright, so what are my final thoughts on the MGP Sonic Head Chinese knockoff thing? For a few dollars, it is a steal at a price. You can't beat the value for money. The fact that it's powered by a single AAA battery offers hours upon hours of entertainment with each NES game. You're pretty much good to go. The manual could be better. There's nothing in it. But it's not too bad. Mine does have a couple of faults, which may happen to yours, may not. I don't know. Mine seems to be a little bit different than the ones that you can get from China. Like I said, mine's the MGP model. I don't know what yours will end up being, but they seem to have all the same games, and they seem to be built exactly identically together. I mean, just look at them. It's identical. It's the same. With the... few faults that I have, which is this spins. I don't know if that's for all of them. I've looked on videos, some have it, some don't. But just so you know, that could be an issue. Also, mine seems to have an electronical fault. Electronical fault? Yes,
an electrical fault. When I've plugged in the AV out cable and turned it on, sometimes the torch would come on. I don't know if it's a fault or a feature or what, but I'd have to take it out, plug it back in, take it out and plug it back in, and then keep turning it on and off, and the light would eventually go off, because I don't want this light on all the time while I'm playing. But yeah, it's not too bad. It's pretty nice. I do like the LED light, and the game lineup is truly fantastic, with the exception of the couple that I couldn't get working, for example, SU Pac-Man. Don't know what the problem there is. I mean, Pac-Man works, so that's all you need, right? So, as a fantastic little games console, not only for kids or for you or for whatever, it's fantastic. It's probably one of the best value for money plug-and-play console type things you can get. And not only that, it's small enough to be a keyring. You can put the wire in your pocket, put this on your keys, and have a little Sonic head following you around. I think it's absolutely fantastic. I highly recommend it. So if you can find one for a couple of dollars on the cheap, which you can get from China, I definitely wholeheartedly recommend you get at least one of these. They're really, really good, and they come in a variety of different colors. It's hard not to recommend them because it's so good. Is it piracy? Yes. Does Nintendo care? Probably. Should you care? No, you're not a corporation. You're just a person who wants to play games. It's a couple of dollars. I'd say go for it. They're old games. They're not being sold on the Switch virtual console, are they? Thanks, Nintendo. Appreciate that. So, a little bit of shade there. But yeah, tell me what you guys think. What do you think of the lineup and what do you think of the games? I think it's absolutely fantastic. It's a little bit of a shame that it's just composite video. I would have liked a little mini HDMI cable on it. Maybe it cost a little bit too much. I don't know. I don't know what their excuse is. I think they're just being cheap. But yeah, the 2.5mm AV cable, a little bit different than that. So I'm actually glad I've got one of those because I didn't actually have one. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. And I'll see you guys next time. Take care, survivors.